In today's video, we're not only going to recreate my first aquarium, but a little bit of storytelling as well.
Woo! That looks good. You guys are gonna love this. I recently found the first 3 aquariums that I ever created and the pictures I took of them.
Yeah, this is back before when digital cameras and computers were really popular. I'm talking 18 years ago. Folks, I celebrate 18 years in the aquarium hobby this month. January 2020 marks 18 years. Anyways, I've been taking pictures and videos and sharing my hobby for all 18 years as shown here. You guys know the story. My first aquarium was a 10-gallon piranha tank. We'll take a look at that here shortly. My next aquarium was like a 37-gallon Walmart tank. This was a community aquarium. We've got some gourami, angelfish, we got a bala shark. I see tiger barbs. What else do I see in here? I see some sort of a tetra and some guppies. Oh man. And then I switched that over to an Oscar aquarium. Guys, I've been keeping Oscars. I kept Oscars exclusively. I told you about this a long time ago, that there was a point in my hobby where I had Oscar fish exclusively. I love them. That's like a year into my hobby I was keeping them. Anyways, about 5 days ago now, I asked you guys on the community tab to my channel. I said, what was your first size aquarium? One of the more popular sizes below or something else. Mine was a 10-gallon tank. Not this exact aquarium, but it was a 10-gallon tank. Whew! Over 33,000 of you guys voted, and over half of you said 10-gallon. Now, there was hundreds of comments as well that said, well, my first one was 5-gallon, and that's as close to 10-gallon as the voting was. Bottom line is this. My first aquarium was a 10-gallon tank, and a lot of your guys's was a 10-gallon tank as well. Out of the 18 years I've been in the aquarium hobby, I've been making videos on YouTube for 12 of them. 2020 is going to mark my 12th year, coming up in a couple of months. During this time, we've done a massive amount of incredible things. We've got incredible and beautiful aquariums, absolutely phenomenal. Oh, but isn't it easy to lose touch with where you came from? Isn't it easy for you, even if you're a new hobbyist, to look at creators like me and think, look at the size of his tank, or look at this, or look at that, I'll never accomplish something like that. And you look at your tank and you're like, oh, you know, I've got a little floating thing and colored gravel and a bunch of little fish. This is nothing compared to, I started there too. Okay, so like I said, the first aquarium I ever had was a 10-gallon aquarium. I'm gonna tell you guys the real story, the truth of how I actually got it. But it came with an internal box filter. If you guys don't recognize these, I actually don't mind these at all. They sit in the corner of your tank. They look pretty good. You hook up an air stone, you put in some biological media, but at the time I was just filling it with carbon, activated carbon and filter floss just to polish the water. No wonder my tank was never cycled. And you pop it in and that's it. Pretty basic, but I eventually did upgrade. Let's go get the supplies and I'll try to mimic what this tank looked like at one point. So we're not only gonna recreate my first aquarium, we're also gonna go to the same places that I got everything for it. Walmart, yeah, yeah. I know, but this is one of the places. At the time you would come here or go to the fish store in the mall. The fish store in the mall has closed since then. This was 18 years ago. Or you could drive an hour away and go to a local fish store in Halifax. Again, I'm in Truro, Nova Scotia. Back then, well, 18 years ago, they also used to sell fish here. They no longer do, which kind of sucks because now I can't rescue all the fish in Walmart. But I do know they still have some supplies here. I check in on stuff every once in a while, but I don't really shop here at all for fish stuff ever. Oh, you know what? I did have a hang on the back filter. Let me just check this picture. Okay, so this is all we have to go by. I took it. So if we look at this black thing right there, this is the hang on the back heater. They don't clip on anymore. I'm not even gonna bother with the heater, but that's the filter over there. That black thing is another filter I ended up adding onto it, and it would have been something like these. So let me get one, even though I would never use this in real life now. Okay, it looks like we're gonna need some, yeah, what kind of gravel is that? Some, I call it clown puke gravel. Looks like that might be some. Only a little bit of it though. And then of course, some fake plants and whatnot. Oh, this is hilarious. Okay, they don't have a shark. We do see a shark in that photo, but they do have a little Nemo that's broken. Oh, there's one that's not. Ugh. I guess this'll do. This is close enough, eh? I don't see a shark. Oh man. We'll get the Nemo.
What is, it looks like it's a rock background of some sort. I don't know if they have any. I think this is their only one. I don't know if this is gonna be good enough. 12 inches by 24 inches. Yeah, this should do it. Does it have rocks on it? I don't know, but that's the only thing they have here. What else? Not much of a selection, half a thing. I think these here are these things here. Oh man, I probably thought that looked awesome. Remember this thing, that's a no fishing sign. So I need something like a no fishing sign. What's this one say? Davy Jones lock. I don't think they're gonna have a no fishing. Buried treasure. Oh, I should have went with that. SpongeBob wasn't a thing that long ago. I guess I can go with this and just rip the plants out. It doesn't have to be exact, but I'd like it to be somewhat accurate or historically accurate. And then the multicolored gravel, obviously. That was a thing for me for some reason. Call it clown puke gravel right here. Oh man, this is bringing back some memories. It's strangely exciting to do this too, like just having fun and just putting in whatever you think looks cute or cool or whatever. I'm definitely having fun with this one. Damn, $99. I don't remember it costing that much, but I guess it has been 18 years.
All right, let's do this. The story goes as follows. I'm gonna set this up as I kind of talk to you guys and walk you through it. Spoiler alert, I'm not filling this with water and adding a piranha to it. I think that that's irresponsible and I have zero plans on keeping this up and going long term. I just thought it was fun to remind myself where I come from and to remind you that we all start somewhere. So the story goes as follows. Look at this gravel. Joey had a troubled, very troubled childhood and youth and even into my teens, of course. Going to the aquarium store, I would see this big, that the store's actually closed now, but I would see this large planted piranha aquarium. Absolutely loved it. It was like the... It was the only time that I was like calm and relaxed was looking at aquariums. I knew I needed to have one. But again, this was a time before I didn't even have a cell phone. Cell phones weren't popular. Nobody really had computers. The internet wasn't as dominant as it is now. So if you were looking to buy something, remember, I don't know if anybody remembers, but you would write down what you have, put on a piece of paper, and at the bottom would be tabs, pull tabs. Well, the story goes as follows. I said that my girlfriend at the time got me a fish tank, surprised me with a fish tank, etc. Knew that that's not really how that went. Truth be told is, I was looking through the newspaper, looking at bulletin boards at the drugstore, down at my apartment where the mailboxes were. Sometimes people would put there, but she was at work and she did see something that says 10-gallon tank for sale. I drove out there, I picked it up and brought it home, but it definitely does sound more heartwarming when it's like, and more sweet if, oh, somebody, your girlfriend got you that and she got you into the hobby, et cetera, et cetera. That's not necessarily how it went. And the reason I'm bringing this up is because I find that like so many people think I have this great and understanding wife, girlfriend, whatever the case might be, and you don't. I'm on the internet. I don't want people to attack my family or people I'm intimate with or anything like that. But truth be told, you know, she really didn't like me being in the hobby. It took a lot of my time and effort and there was no... I wasn't making any money from it because it wasn't a business plan, but I was putting so much money into it, etc. So it's, again, we have way more in common than you might think. The person that owned that 10-gallon tank before me was a little old lady. I remember, I went right into her house. My girlfriend at the time did come with me. She waited out in the car, but I knew nothing about aquariums, so I didn't know what I was buying, but I'm glad I did. Yeah, so that tank and that picture, it looks like... I'll put this picture up and we'll see if we can mimic. This gravel isn't identical. Oh, and the tank that I bought originally didn't have a light or a top. I didn't know that aquariums had lids and tops at the time, but it was a very basic setup. I think I paid like 20 or 30 bucks for it, which at the time I know was overpriced.
So this probably went more like centered. Oh, you know what I gotta put on first? Yeah, no, I had a ton of family and friends, and a lot of people just make fun of me for the fish I kept. Oh, it does have the rocks on the inside. Yeah, I probably just take this on. I didn't know you could squeegee them on at the time. Anyways, one of the things I kind of want to... One of the things that I do want to touch base on is like how everybody viewed me at the time. Going from Joey, the guy that like had a troubled past, did some time, to Joey's a little nerd keeping fish, and it's funny. So everybody would tease me and make fun of me, my friends, family, but I never thought it was funny. I was like, this is the only thing positive that I've had in my life that I can remember, and you're making fun of me for it. Clearly I didn't care, I stuck to it. Did what I was passionate about, did what I loved, stayed true to myself, and got a million subscribers on YouTube. Who's laughing now? Okay, this castle looks like, I can't believe I bought a castle. I should keep this stuff on so I can return it, but yeah, I might use it eventually. This isn't actually that bad. This tank is actually pretty exciting because it reminds me of that when I was setting up a tank. Like I had a piranha, so I wanted a little shark to act like it was part of a dangerous area, but I couldn't find a shark today. So you're just gonna get little Nemos. And a no fishing sign. Oh man, I put everything over there? I said we're gonna rip this off. I guess it looks okay. 10-gallon tank with a piranha that was probably 3 inches. It was a red-belly piranha too, so they get to a foot long. I eventually took him back, exchanged him, bought a bigger tank, etc. You guys know the drill. We all do it. But yeah, I just hope that this really hits home for a lot of you guys that know, like, even somebody like me that's so popular on the internet started probably a lot worse off than you. I had no support. Nobody was really that supportive of me, not until I became successful. And you know, it just feels good to make this video in general. One, remind myself where I came from, humbling myself once again, and letting you guys know that we have way more in common than you probably think. I am just a regular guy. When I shut this camera off, I just go back to being Joey that, you know, cracks jokes and likes to have fun and hang out with his kids and do that type of thing. And I still got a bit of an attitude problem. I don't like when people disrespect me. I still struggle with that. I think this looks like a, yeah, something like that. But yeah, so don't let the whole follower count fool you when it comes to anybody. This doesn't look bad. I actually really like it. It could use a light. Heck, maybe I do fill this up. Maybe I do keep it. This isn't all this bad. Look at it. It definitely needs a light, and it doesn't look that great on camera, but I don't mind it at all. This is my first aquarium, guys. And I had a piranha. Oh, man. I feel like this is close. Yeah? I feel like it's as close as I can get. It's the only picture I have. It's not that clear. I think it must have been like a disposable camera. Wow. How the heck did I go from this to all of this? Wow. Absolutely phenomenal. Man, what a decade I've had. What a transition. 12 years of showing you guys my hobby. 18 years of enjoying it. Anyways, folks, that was my first aquarium. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you for coming along for the ride. This kind of brought up a lot of feelings and emotions for me. I know that it kind of got a little weird there for a second as I was setting this up, but I think that's the overall effect that I want. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you're not subscribed to this channel yet and you want to see more videos like this, don't bother subscribing because I'm not doing it again.